change management today and in the context of personal change, okay? How do you change yourself? And more importantly, for the sake of the organization, for USM yang kita cintai ini, how do you can also change the organization, okay? So I will try to bring our discussion from the perspective of an individual towards an organization, okay? And please have your kertas handy because we do some exercise as well, okay? And I'm also trying some technology lah, tak nak ketinggalan. So I have some mentimeters here and there, not too many, but it is also something that can get all of you to be interactive. And taklah boring sangat mendengar my talk satu hala. So ladies and gentlemen, as I said, change management is never easy, okay? Because change management requires your will to change. Okay, nak pakai teknologi dah tak jalan lah. Okay. Yeah. Alright. So this is always the balance or the contradictory in life that we have to go through. Time for change versus daily routine. Right? We are all in our daily routine. Today, I broke your daily routine because you have to come here. Otherwise, all of you will have to go to your office. It becomes so routine. Okay? So, time for change. I will just give an example what I have changed in my own ways as far as presentation is concerned. Okay? Of course, all of us start our life as a especially among us academic, we use PowerPoint a lot. Okay? So, and I have been using Mac for many years. And I have a PowerPoint in my Mac. Okay? So, that was my comfort zone. Right? PowerPoint, kita dah biasa buat PowerPoint. But when I bought my new Mac, okay, upgrade sikit, I decided, let's try Keynote. Okay, because I don't want PowerPoint. Well, I have to buy PowerPoint or PowerPoint online, so I didn't like it. So I said, let's try Keynote. Okay, so that decision was made about 2 months ago, and I have been struggling because it's a different software. Okay, so that is a good example where you have to go out of your comfort zone, something that is so routine to you. You know where the buttons are, and to change to another software that perhaps may be better, but to me it was more of convenience because it comes with, it is a software that is already in the Mac. Okay, so I decided to learn, and of course doing this presentation I learned much more lah. Okay, because we tend to only know the minimal when we do our presentation. Okay, so that is a good example how we need to change from daily routine to something different. But I will bring to you why we need to change and how do we change. I think that is very important. Okay? So ladies and gentlemen, my first exercise. Oh, tak boleh jauh-jauh benda ni. Jauh-jauh dia hilang. Okay, ingat. Canggih sangat. Okay? Alright. Take out your paper. This is very difficult, you know. I was doing when I did this in Kelantan over the weekend, okay, when I did my presentation, I was asking myself, apa aku buat beza for the past week? For the past month. Malam tadi baru aku terfikir pasal keynote. Okay. So, in our life, things are quite very routine. So, ladies and gentlemen, in 3 minutes, work in progress. Kelantan and kejuruteraan as well. Pakai kertas aja. Ini tak ada teknologi. This is for you. Okay. What changes have you made from your routine or always within the last month? Okay. 3 minutes. Tak sempat nak letak countdown. Think hard. What have you made? Prazinal tak boleh kelentong lah. What have you made changes to yourself? Pribadi, kerja, whatever, within the last month. And you can add, why did you change? Why did you make that change? And what was the outcome of that change? Okay? Saya nak bawa you all to start thinking, because when you are hearing such presentation, you are anticipating to sit here for 2 hours. You need to be interactive and you need to think, because mendengar dengan membuat is a different skill. So this is just for you, okay? For you to ponder. Okay, if you have done that, I want to know your background. Okay, Kejuruteraan and Kelantan also, please. Ni first time nak belajar ni. Please get into menti@.com and code 639767. www.menti.com, code 639767. And I would like to know your background. If you are a ketua jabatan, that's me. I put satu tu. Saya silap. Saya pengusaha tertinggi. Lupa. Okay, never mind. I'll change that. So I would like to know also your background so that I can have a profile of our discussion. So dua work in progress. Satu, what have you changed within the last month? And also your profile. Tolong semua keluar handphone. Mesti ada handphone. Wah, cepat lah. I wanted to make sure that this works. Dapat? Tak bawa handphone. Tak bawa handphone, keluar laptop. Pakai secure. Boleh. Di Kelantan dengan di Kejuruteraan pun boleh. Seluruh dunia boleh. Okey, kita ada 3 minit lagi. Offline. Tak bayar ni ke? Ha? Tak bayar bil. Pakai wifi. Mungkin laju. Orang yang first time mungkin dia tak biasa. Dah. Pilih satu je. Kalau you ketua jabatan, pilih ketua jabatan je lah. Dah, kena masuk tu ada. Yes, penyelia. Kalau you seorang penyelia tapi you bukan ketua jabatan, maknanya there's somebody that you are, you penyelia, you penilai pertama. So because there is context of discussion today. Okay. Sebenarnya you are going to be a leader, a penyelia to someone. Even yourself. Okay, saya bagi 2 minit lagi. Tak sempat nak belajar macam mana nak buat countdown on screen. Ada dah, dah masuk YouTube tapi tak sempat lagi nak buat. Kena tambah ilmu. 90 dah, okay. Okay, continue to do so. I will switch balik. Okay, so I hope you have already reflected. Reflection is the first thing that you need to do before change can happen. Okay, so that's why before I even begin and show the outcome of this session, I would like for you to think about what changes you have made for yourself within the last month. Okay, Susan, saya senang. Within my last month, I changed my hairstyle. Itu pun satu lagi, lupa lah tulis. Okay. Alright. So let us proceed. This is the outcome of this session, and I hope by the end of the session, you would have achieved all this, okay? Attain all this. First, you are able to identify matters that need change. Okay, lepas ni, I will ask another question. Just now, what were the changes that you have made? Okay, it's not easy. Sometimes you don't realize that you have made changes. Okay, so by the end of this session, inshallah, all of you will be able to identify matters that need change for yourself, for your family, for your organization, for your team. Okay, and I think this is also very important. You are able to agree that unavoidably change has to happen. Okay, and that is the motivation of change. And I will talk through with you what I mean by this. Okay, number three is that you are able to initiate and manage change in order to achieve the desired results. Okay, I've chosen the words carefully because you have to initiate change. Change will not happen. Well, change does happen on its own, which I will explain later. But as far as the context of our discussion and the outcome of this discussion, apa pasal? You need to be able to initiate and manage change in order to achieve the desired results. Okay. And finally, tunggu kejap. Okay, and finally, you will be the agent of change, right? This is the desire. This is my ultimate aim when I design my presentation today, when I agree to this talk. It is for all of you to be the agent of change. Okay, so I do hope by the end of this session, through our participation, we will achieve all this four, inshallah. Okay, so let me just give some thoughts about change. Okay, I was not able to baca banyak-banyak sangat, but these are all from my own thoughts. Mana yang I referred, I will cite it. There are things that are uncontrollable. Okay, changes to our surroundings, people, partner, husband and wife, kita pun change. Okay, because we age, so there are changes that happen. Sometimes kita sedar, sometimes kita tak sedar, sometimes kita ignore, right? So there are changes to our surrounding, people, environment, world. If you realize that things are getting colder in Malaysia. Baru ni kat Kota Baru, baru bangun pagi, sejuk lah. 19-21 degree Celsius. Okay. So things are changing. Of course, we have been warned on the climate change and whatnot. But things are changing around us. The world is changing. So ladies and gentlemen, these are the things that we need to realize that these are uncontrollable change. Walaupun in some aspect we can avoid them, or we may have the will and the means to deviate that change, but it is something that normally is uncontrollable as far as a person is concerned. Okay, change to our own self. Physically, emotionally, mentally, sometimes we also do not realize. Okay, so I categorize it. Of course, you can go more and more, but just for the sake of time, these are two that are uncontrollable. Then there are something that you can control. Usually, this is in response to the changes in the first category of uncontrollable. Okay. You need to adjust yourself. Sometimes to avoid discomfort. Right? So kalau changes happen to you physically, so you need, you know, sometimes some of us have to resort to tongkat because kita punya kaki dah tak kuat. So those are the changes that you have to make. And you have to make that decision. Sometimes ego comes in. Okay? Sometimes you are so comfortable about yourself that you do not want to change, to the detriment of many things. Okay, saya nak we reflect on this. Is still at personal stage. I'm still talking at personal stage. So this is the time for us to reflect, myself included, because there's a lot of things in life that demands change from us, but we do not respond accordingly. And sometimes it is for our own good, to avoid discomfort, to improve our livelihood. Okay, kadang-kadang our ways, our routine are detrimental to the way we work, the way we produce, the way we do things, and sometimes you sometimes, okay, especially kalau kita punya ego tinggi lah, kan? Kalau kita bangsa tak boleh ditegur. So sometimes you do not know that you have to change as well. You need to change also to assimilate better in society. Okay? How do you, because society changes. For example, for us, among us lecturers in here, how do you change your ways of teaching? Because your audience are different. Okay? So I think this is something that we have to reflect upon ourselves. And finally, sometimes to survive. Okay? And to survive is where the organization that all of us love so much, USM, is at that stage. Okay? We need to survive. And I will tell you why. So that's why change management is also very important, but it has to come from an individual perspective first before we can go to the organization. But what I am trying to also highlight today are the strategic changes. Okay? These are the ones that all of us as individual who are, you know, getting the risk from the university need also to participate. This is how we change our working habits to improve productivity and efficiency. I started off with, you know, time to change versus routine. This is where we need to ask ourselves at all levels, eh? What are the changes that we need to do so that we improve our productivity and efficiency? Unfortunately, every year, year in, year out, LPP, SKT, please reflect. Changes happen or cut and paste? Okay? Changes happen or cut and paste? Reflection. Okay, sebab tu saya kata mula-mula ni is a time of reflection. Okay? If you then are able to achieve number one, alhamdulillah, you will be a better person. You will be a better staff. You will be a better asset to your organization, to your department, to your university, and to yourself, because you will find the satisfaction of doing so. Okay? That's number one. Number two, amar ma'ruf nahi munkar. Changing others. Okay? Itu adalah perintah Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Okay? Kita kena amar ma'ruf menggalakkan kebaikan dan mencegah kemungkaran. That is part of change. We need to change others. How do you do that if you cannot change yourself? These are where kepimpinan melalui taladan comes in, you know? You have to lead by action, walk the talk. These are all the terms that we use. Not all of us can do that, including myself. I have my weaknesses. But it is a reminder to all of us. Okay? You need to change others because that is required. Okay? That is required for us to do. And beyond that, ladies and gentlemen, if you can change the organization, you are indeed the agent of change. Okay, so I was just looking at the clip arts on this, actively generating exceptional new thinking. Okay, agent of change. Actively generating exceptional new thinking. So it has to come from thinking. Kita kena fikir dulu what to change. So this is what I would like to invite all of us to ponder, to reflect, and also to be desirable towards it. Because this is one of the outcome of this presentation. Okay? And for that, we have to ask, why change? Okay? Why do we need to change? So I have always loved quotation by Dato' OO, mantan VC kita, when he talks about being relevant to dominant, to prominent, to eminence. Because I've used it many times to motivate my own staff on the meaning of being relevant, dominant, prominent, and eminence. Okay? So, I think you can also understand what the word means. If you don't change, ladies and gentlemen, thing that you have to avoid, from relevant, you may become irrelevant. Okay? And unfortunately, in USM, we can see that there are many irrelevant persons. Maknanya, what does it mean? If you are not around, things move on. Because the fact remains, nobody is indispensable. Betul. Tapi, if we are irrelevant, means if we are not functioning, we are not there, the productivity of our department is not being affected at all. Okay? That means you are in the danger of being irrelevant. And kalau the survival of the university comes to a point where we have to fire because we have to survive, which we have not come to that, but we never know, na'uzubillah min zalik, the money that we have, the condition that we had, we are facing, maybe some of you don't realize it, but we top management have been reminded again and again, okay, about the criticalness of situation as far as money is concerned, because semua kita dapat gaji kita every month without fail. Syukur, hashtag syukur selalu. But you must realize we are not in the same good old days where money comes pouring from the sky. Okay? I have to remind all of you. That's why the demand for change is even stronger. And we cannot afford to have any one of us to fall from being relevant to irrelevant. Okay? So this is again point of reflection. Are we relevant or are we irrelevant? And please use this line to encourage your team. Okay, because we know in our team there are people who are less relevant. Maybe not totally irrelevant, but they are less relevant. And we need to encourage them to go the other way from relevant to dominant. Okay? I will use again the analogy that I always use with my staff. What does relevant mean? You all paham. Maknanya, you have a function and you serve that function and you actually are useful to the organization. But we demand further because you need to change from relevant to dominant. So what is dominant? Dominant is when you are always in the list of anything that people would like to do. Okay? Maknanya, if there's a project, your name mesti ada dalam that list. That is when you are already dominant. You are being noticed because you are good. Okay? So that's dominant. Very easy to understand. Okay? So if you are always in the list of whatever that is going on, then you are already dominant. Alhamdulillah. Move on. Continue to change. Continue to progress. Because we also like you to become prominent. Then the question is, what is prominent? Prominent is when your name is always first in the list. Okay? Kita ada long list, 10 orang. Yeah, everybody will always remember you. Macam I sekarang, I want to find task force after task force. So if your name appears in my thinking, you are already dominant. But if your name is always the first that I think, then alhamdulillah, you have come to that problem. You don't have to know. People will know. But you need to bring yourself to a point where you are at that prominent stage. And that is the apex or the culmination of your career. Okay? Belum lagi sebenarnya. Ada lagi satu word called eminence. Okay? Eminence eh? Saya bagi contoh lah. Orang tukar tarikh sebab you tak boleh datang. Itu eminence lah. Okay? Okay? People change the date because you cannot make it. Okay? Selalu tu, kalau saya punya diary sebab penuh. Tapi bukan sebab eminent lah tu, sebab diary penuh. But if you are a speaker, you have been invited to give a keynote. Okay? And unfortunately, you cannot make it. The organizer will shift the date to accommodate you. That is prominence. Okay? But please do it ikhlas to also get the benefit di akhirat. Okay? You have to balance that. So ladies and gentlemen, this is where we would like you to go. Okay, we would like you to change towards being a better person, a better worker, a better insan, a better hamba Allah. Okay? So, of course, many of us know this, hari ini harus lebih baik dari semalam. Kemarin tu orang Indonesia ya, ambil clip art. But today needs to be better than yesterday and tomorrow better than today. I thought it was a hadith. When I look into it, ada yang mengatakan dia hadith da'if. Okay? So, could be a words of wisdom. Right? But this is, again, religion also teaches that today has to be better than tomorrow. Tomorrow has to be better than today. So, that is change, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? So, this first part of my talk is all about ourselves. Because if we don't change, we will never be able to change others, including our spouse. And for us all husbands, that is tanggungjawab utama kita. Okay? And for us, husband and wife, our children, our family, that is also our tanggungjawab. So therefore, change is something that we cannot, it's unavoidable. It must happen. So, self-exercise two. Reflect, pejam mata, tutup lampu. Eh? Sebenarnya, penyampai nak minum air dengan duduk. Okay? Identify one matter that you need to change about yourself. Saya tahu. I have to lose weight. Doktor ada kat sini. Okay? So, itu nak kena, that's already in my list. Okay? Successful for some time. But being TNC ni itulah, Puan Noria bagi makan banyak sangat. Meeting bagi makan. Eh? So that's another change that I have to make. Okay? Alright, seriously ladies, this is about yourself. Sebab lepas ni I nak bawa you about organisation. Okay? So what do you think is the most, sekarang saya dah reflect eh. What do you need to change most? Okay, it's not too late, azam baru. Masih baru bulan Februari. Alright, saya senyap. Reflect upon yourself. Semua orang. Saya dah cakap saya nak kurus. So you all semua. Masuk Faizal ni semua. Kena tulis. Yang ambil kamera ni pun. What do you need to change about yourself immediately? Okay? And why do you want to change that? Okay? Alright. Tak payahlah 5 minit. 3 minit dah lah. Okay, can we move on? Kalau tak sempat, fikir balik nanti lah. Eh? Malam-malam ni reflect. Eh? Muhasabah. Okay. We are being asked to do self-reflection daily. Right? Before we sleep. Daripada mengarut tengok Facebook tak habis-habis sebelum tidur kan? Reflection. Okay? Dan jangan lupa baca doa. Janganlah Facebook is the last thing you see. Okay? So, ladies and gentlemen, you are now an agent of change. Congratulations. Yeah? We tepukkan lah. Eh? Saya melantik anda sebagai agent of change. Okay. So let's move on. I have another hour. Let's move on to a bit of theory. But this theory is an important theory. Okay? This gentleman by the name of Kurt Lewin, that lives in the last century, came out with this theory. Okay? And it is self-explanatory. This is where we are now. Okay? Or desired state. It could be now, because we have not been changing for many years. It's also something that we would like to aspire towards. Okay? But in order to do so, this is life. We need driving forces. We need motivation. We need to hear this talk. Okay? We need somebody to membebel. That is also motivation for change. Okay? My worst critic is... Siapa? My worst critic. Prof. Farhan's worst critic is apa? Prof. Azrina. Sebab tu aku tak cakap pasal kerja kat rumah. So, kena bambu kiri kanan. Okay? She has not seen this presentation. I don't know whether she has opened my laptop secretly, but she doesn't know my password. She only know my password for phone, but not for computer. Because pakai tangan, pakai jari. Okay? So, ladies and gentlemen, the driving forces are there. Maybe you don't realize it. Okay? The uncontrollable changes around us are actually the driving forces. Okay? But this side of the equation is the evil. Okay? Our enemy. Restraining forces, obstacles for change. And in order for us to understand the dynamism and the ecosystem of change, we need to identify these two. And we need to win because we need to push the obstacles. And that's what Kurt Lewin says. Simple. Simple theory. Okay? But you need to dissect them. This is driving force to change at the organization level. Okay? As I say, I'm going to move to organization now. You have seen this. This is our vision and mission statement and our apex thrust. We see this, but do we understand it? Okay, tak apalah, itu masing-masing tanya jawab. Then we see this, the shifts. Penggunaan word shift also require change, because shift without change will not move. Okay, shifting gear means changing gear. So, the idea behind the Malaysian Education Blueprint purposely use the word shift. Because it is a verb to signify change. And we are all being strategic about this. These are the motivation for change. Okay? And recently, we are being bombarded by this word, Fourth Industrial Revolution, which says that we need to change. Otherwise, many of us will be irrelevant. Why? Because robots will replace us. Because automation will replace us. Cuba reflect kat universiti ni pun, berapa banyak kerja yang dah tak relevan. So we will not know whether this become the reality or it is still science fiction. But unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, we are seeing it, you know. Even houses now are being 3D printed. Okay? You can build a house like a Lego house, a real house like a Lego house. And not using hands, but using automation and machine. It's real. We are already going to showcase it in USM. So what will happen to the construction industry? What will happen to the bricklayers? What will happen to the concrete mixer? What will happen to cement? Okay, these are real. So coming back to closer to us, what will happen to us lecturers? What will happen to us professors? What will happen to us instructors that are in the labs? Do we really need this session anymore? Because this is live. I can just tape it and do it in my room. And everybody can listen as well. So these are the questions. When we talk about Fourth Industrial Revolution, it's a real threat. Okay, and it is coming very fast. that is definitely a motivational for change. So I can go on and on, but enough lah. I think you can reflect. But what is maybe sad, how many of us have actually reflected upon our vision and mission statement, which is a beautiful vision and mission statement. Okay? Because it is aligned with nilai-nilai murni. Okay? The virtuous values in religion, in life. Okay? We are encouraged to help others. Not only to help others, but to change others. Not only to change others, but to transform others. And we are transforming the higher education. So are we doing that? Well, in some aspects, yes. In some aspects, no. Are we leading? Yes. In some aspect, perhaps we were. Perhaps now we are no longer leading. So that is a point of contention why we need to change. Is USM actually leading and transforming higher education? Or are we being led and we need to catch up? Okay. Are we the producer of the blue ocean? Or are we just swimming in the red ocean? Because everybody else have done it, but we have not done it, but we need to do it. So these are questions that need to drive us to change. Semua kita. Okay, semua kita. Tidak kira siapa kita di USM. So, what are the restraining force? SIRS. Comfort zone. To me, this is the most critical attitude that all of us have that restrain us from change. Because we are in our comfort zone. Including our students. The reason that they do not perform, they do not push themselves, they are not desirable to be the hebat student that we want them to be, is because they get into their comfort zone easily. That's why, you know, when we are in majlis, we tend to sit among our friends. We don't sit with other friends from other universities. That is your comfort zone. Okay? Comfort zone also shows that we stick to our routine because we are very comfortable to that. So that is the reason why a lot of people and a lot of organizations do not want to change. Okay? And that is an attitude issue. So in order to do that, how do we change? Okay, I will try to give some formula, which may not work, which may work, inshallah. Peer pressure, saing-saing kita ni, can also be very, very dangerous and also contagious. Okay? Apa hang nak susah-susah ni? Gaji dapat setiap bulan. Okay? But that cannot be promised all the time. Gaji dapat, but last year we were not able to assure our gaji until bulan 9. Okay, for the whole year. Peer pressure is something that you have to bersilat and restrain and know what, when to say no, when to say yes. Okay. Peer pressure can also be family pressure, can also be subordinate pressure, can also be boss pressure. So you need to balance. You need to know why the motivation for change is important. Why you need to change is important. Inability, knowledge, capability. We don't have that. We don't have enough of that. So we need to learn. Because if you don't learn, you will feel diffident. You are not confident to change. Because you are in your comfort zone. You want to change, you need knowledge. Not only guts and bravery, but you need knowledge. So you need to acquire knowledge. Even at my age, I had to learn Mentimeter. Okay, alhamdulillah, senang je nak belajar. Sebab Prof. Karim ada buat video. Saya pun tengoklah video dia. Okay? So that's the beauty of current ways of learning. Okay? Anak-anak kita, they study pakai YouTube. Risk averse. This is another problem. Okay? Not willing to take risk. Calculated risk. Again, comfort zone related. Okay? And finally, okay, what is it for me? Ada kira ke LPP? Ada kira ke naik pangkat? Okay, needing incentive. This is not good. Okay, unfortunately, we are seeing more and more of this. You only do if there is or there are incentives. Okay, what happened to nilai-nilai murni, nilai-nilai USM? Sacrifices. Okay, so this is something that we have to reflect upon. If many of our staff, your subordinate, will only change, shift gear, improve when there's only incentives, then we need to work even harder because the values are diminishing. The values are different. So as a leader, as a supervisor, we need to realize that. We need to know why are they like this. Maybe we have spoon-fed them too much. We have rewarded them unnecessarily. Sebab itu peribahasa Melayu ada mengatakan buat baik berpada-pada, buat jahat jangan sekali. Quite late in my life that I appreciated that words of wisdom. Buat baik berpada-pada, buat jahat jangan sekali. Apa hal nak buat berpada-pada? Buat baik sebaik-baik yang mungkin lah. No, rupa je orang Melayu zaman tok-tok nenek kita had full of wisdom. Buat baik berpada-pada. Don't overdo it. Okay, that's what it means. So sometimes needing incentive is a result of buat baik tak berpada-pada. Okay, okay, reflect. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the tug of war that we are facing. Change agent dengan changing recipients. Always. Okay. Dua orang tu tak boleh menang dengan tiga orang. Susah. Anda letak Prof. Farhan kat itu mungkin boleh menang. But maybe itu pun susah. Because sometimes you are two, the change recipient is the whole university. Okay. So that is the challenge that we have to understand. Because before we go into war, we need to know who are our adversaries, what our ammunition, what our strategies. So changing is going to war. So these are the things that we need to avoid. Okay? So now I hope by now, ladies and gentlemen, you all can realize why we need to change. Okay? I've given some examples here and there, private life, organization-wise, which I will repeat at the end later so that we can do some exercise. But after realizing the word why, which is very important, okay, I just finished reading a book called Why. Simple aja, okay? And why is a very powerful word. It motivates you because when you do things, how many of you, when you do things, you do not know why you have to do it? Because it's being instructed to you, because it's an SOP, because it is a tradition, because we have done it for many years. But why? Why must Senate do this? Why must MPSU do this? Why must we go through these steps? We never ask. So we usually take it as it is. Not that we want to criticize, but sometimes things have changed. Situations have changed. Requirements have changed. Context have changed. Okay, this is where sometimes ISO can also be a trap. Okay. Sometimes SOPs can also be a trap because you don't understand why we did the SOP. So let's move on to look at how. This is my experience, ladies and gentlemen. I did not find anywhere. This is my experience I'm going to share. It may have worked for me. It may not work for everybody. Okay, but it is just a guide. How do we change? I will go through five steps that we need to go through. We need to make that change. Okay. First is the most important thing. An agreement that change must happen. So in any situation, ladies and gentlemen, there must be this self-agreement. You must know why we need to change. Otherwise, you will not do it sincerely. You will not have your self-motivation. And when you face with roadblocks, you will give up. So number one is a must. And this is where, in the tug of war, in Kurt Lewin's forces of change, you need to be able to get the buying in so that everybody that you would like to change agrees to change. And you can tell. As a leader, you can tell. Okay, you can tell whether the person is doing it just because it is an instruction or it is something that he or she also shares in terms of its values, its motivation, and its desired outcomes. Okay? So that, to me, is a must. Once you have gotten that, okay, then you need to create a situation where you need to motivate others so that they can join you. Okay, because there is a theory of change, not many people will join you because they will be in their comfort zone. Okay? So how do you do that? How do you change that? You need to create motivational factors. You need to create situations. You need to create logos. You need to create mottos. Okay? So that people see, they also know why we need to change. Okay? Number three is also equally important. In an organization as big as USM, you need the political support, the will of the boss. Because changes doesn't always come from the top. Changes can come from everywhere. But changes sometimes require policy change. Changes sometimes require money. Okay? Changes sometimes require reorganization of governance. So, you need that political will. You need to know also how to play politics. Okay, in the sense of change, yeah. Right, I will explain. Yeah. Then, we also need to manage the transition of change. Because that threshold of change is the most critical point. Because there will still be tug of war between those who want to change and those who resist to change. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, we must also sustain the momentum. Sustainability of change is also important because it can always go back to normal. Okay? Macam I lah. Lost some weight, Dr. Mina, gain back some weight. Okay? Example. It's not easy. Okay? You need support. So in change of an organization, changes in organization, same. We also need to have that support. We need to sustain. Okay? So let us dissect one by one. So these are some examples where we need, unfortunately, yang sebelah, this left side is so few and apart. Strengthening or adding driving forces. Not easy to do. Okay, because most of the time when we request for change, masuk tinggal kiri, keluar tinggal kanan. Especially the mode of instruction is something that is nagging, menyakitkan hati, tidak berhemah. Okay, we can also reflect as parents. We do this sometimes. So this is where we need to add more strength. How do you get the buying in? Not easy, ladies and gentlemen, not easy. Okay? But that has to be done. These are the tactical moves that we have to do. We want to win. Unfortunately, sebelah sana banyak. Those are individual resistance. Okay? Organizational resistance. The entire organization do not want to change. Okay? The highest body does not want to change. So how do you encourage change? But if you are motivated enough, then you have to come up with a tactical strategy to do so. Because you know the need to change is there. There's no way that you cannot change. If you don't change, you do not survive. You as the organization. When the organization does not survive, we also do not survive. Ladies and gentlemen, the difference between public sector and private sector are now narrowing. Okay? This is the truth. Okay? This is the truth. We are already biting on our reserves. Biasa ada banyak reserve. Dah 50 tahun umur. But we are biting it. Because we do not get operational budget. For the past 3 years. Okay. Tahu budget USM berapa? Satu tahun? 1.1 billion. That's how big we are. We are the most expensive university. 1.1 billion. We are even bigger than state of Perlis and Kedah, I was told. Punya operational budget. So when we do not get our operational budget from the government, we have to find our own money. Okay? So that's why we need to change. We need to avoid wastage. We need to reduce expenditure. We need to generate income. We need to do more with less. Ini semua sini ni. Semua sini ni. But, who cares? Who cares? Individual resistant. I get my gaji. I get my pay every month. There's no problem. I can still go and shopping. Buy one bag full of kain. Siapa? Alhamdulillah, rezeki ada. I mean, people are saying, malam we were in one hotel, full, makan lunch. So we say, where is the problem? Okay, pergi Mekah, full of Malaysia. Where is the problem? Rezeki. Tapi ada yang marginalized and we do not see. Other among us are less fortunate. But as an organization, ladies and gentlemen, if we do not change, if we do not improve our performance, if we are not able to entice and bring foreign students, we are not able to entice and bring students to our university, it is about survival. Okay? So as we are trying to motivate everybody to change, the restraining is there. And sometimes organizational, we cannot change. Senat, Bendahari, HR, PUU, cakap semua ni. Pejabat TNCA, how do we change? How do we facilitate? Okay? Sometimes we want to change, but our action doesn't seem to promote change. That's organizational change. Okay? So, we need to also do this. Removing or reducing restraining forces. How do we do this? This is the headache. Siapa dekan dan ketua jabatan dan pengarah kat sini, you understand what I'm saying. It's not easy. How you tackle majlis is this balance. Okay? Changing the direction of some of the forces. Okay? Ini prominence in another way. Farama dah gelak. Dia boleh datang kita tukar tarikh. Okay? Adalah kan dalam majlis kita kan ada orang ni negatif saja. The black hats, they do not want to change. Check, ada cuti. Cuti kita tukar. Majlis dilakukan, ditukar kerana sebab-sebab berkenaan. Padahal because that person is on holiday. In Umrah. Okay, example. That is also prominent lah. Or eminent. But, you need to also know how to do that. Because sometimes, when there are too much resistance, too many resistance from left and right, you just get tired. And you need to have success stories. You need to win your wars, your battles before you can even move. So you need to be smart. So you need to identify who are those that you need to bersilat against. Okay? Alright, let's move on. So this is just mind the gap. Siapa orang London suka ni, mind the gap. That gap is important. Because when we want to change, we need to know where we are. Where we are and where we want to go is the gap. Sometimes, ladies and gentlemen, we do not take time to do this. Okay, very dangerous. We want to move forward, but we do not know where we are. So you need to mind the gap. Okay, and how do you do that? Okay, macam-macam cara. This is an example that I took from something that we have already known for many years. But unfortunately, we have not solved it. The APEC strategic approach. This is the blue ocean canvas. Bureaucracy in governance is something that we need to eliminate or reduce. This is a motivational statement. Ask ourselves, if you are doing it, this is part of your job, including my office, because I am part of bureaucracy in governance. If I don't facilitate, if I don't hasten, if I don't improve the speed, being at there, being at that office, I know everybody will be stopped. Everybody will be delayed. And the outcome is that that poor student who is hoping for our decision will just be give up and go to the dark side of restraining forces. Mungkin dia boleh support kita, but they can shift to the dark side. Okay? So that's how dangerous, risky, when we do not understand this, bureaucracy and governance. We also have a problem of talent resources and gaps in resources. Okay, this is bigger, but this is even more telling. Okay, this is a strategic canvas for talent, something that we did 10 years ago. Okay, we have said that we need to eliminate and reduce barriers and obstacles. These are the restraining forces, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, we already said unnecessary bureaucracy.